So welcome back again to KD English course today with me, Miss Yeti. So today, before we start, as usual, we're going to pray first. Okay, everyone, you can turn on your microphone. And if you can turn on your camera, that will be great. We can see your beautiful and your handsome faces. All right, let's pray together, everyone. Praying start.
Thank you, God, for the words.
Thank God for the words.
For the beautiful day.
Thank God for
our lesson and activity.
This bless our lesson and activity today. Amen.
Okay, thank you for praying together. Okay, so in our last meeting, we talk about the tenses, right? So we talk about the tenses and let me check again. Let me open my file first. Okay, before we start, let's play the game first, okay? Good, so the game is about the past tense, past verb, okay? Let me share you my whiteboard. Okay, let me open this one for you. Good. Are you ready with the past verb?
Yes.
Because today we are still going to talk about the tenses, which is it will make you a little bit mungkin agak serius ya. But it's okay because however you will need to know about the tenses. Nanti kalau kalian mau, okay, some of you are in the junior high school now, some of you are still in the elementary school. Nanti kalian akan, supaya kalian terbiasa memakai tenses. Karena kalau kalian kuliah nanti, tes ujian masuknya itu semua tenses ya. Jadi mau nggak mau kalian harus belajar. Oke, okay? Good. Are you ready?
Yes.
You can Google also. It's okay. You can Google. But let's see how fast are you Googling with the past tense verb. Okay. So we're going to talk about the past tense verb. I will write down here the past tense verb. Past verb. So what you have to do is you have to okay, let me so you have to guess the verb two, okay? The verb two. For example, I will write down here. I will write down eat. And then you have to turn on, you can turn on your microphone and then you can say what is the past verb for eat? Anyone? This is example.
Eaten.
Eight. Verb two.
Eight.
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 Eight. Good. Okay, this is the example. Okay, verb two, yeah? Not verb three, remember? Okay, here we go. Are you ready? Good. Yeah. Kita mulai dari yang mudah, ya? How do you... This one. What? Stop becomes?
Stop it.
Stop it. Double P, yeah, stopped. Okay, good. Next. You want to have access to this whiteboard or not? Kalian mau mau bisa nulis-nulis sini atau enggak? Enggak usah ya. Biar Miss aja yang nulis ya. Okay, good. And then the next one. Okay, this one.
So.
So, okay, good. C, that the past verb is so. Kita sekalian belajar verb ketiganya yuk. Verb ketiganya apa?
Seen.
Seen.
Seen, good. Okay, next. Okay, agak cepat ya. Do. Do.
Did.
Good. Verb ketiganya apa?
Do did done.
Done. Good. Next. Ready? Hmm. Yeah. Maybe you don't really know this. Blow. Oh, okay, okay, okay.
Blow.
Blue. All right. How do you write down blow? Blue, yeah, actually blue.
B L E W.
And then last one is
blown.
Blown.
Blown. Blow artinya apa? Blow artinya meni. Blow the balloon.
Meniup.
Meniup balon. Okay, good. Next. What about? Okay, mirip dengan yang ini. Biar kalian nggak bingung. Now, what about this one? Fly. Sama seperti yang tadi. Mirip.
Flew.
Flew. And the Blown. Past participle is flown. The balloon is flown. Balonnya terbang. Okay, good. Next. Kok pada diam aja? Udah pernah ngapalin ini atau belum? Aza? Renza? Zia? Altaf? Aza udah pernah ngapalin ini belum, Za?
Sedikit, Bu.
Sedikit. Nah, yeah. Sekarang harus banyak. Oke, okay, kalian udah mau masuk SMA kan? Aza udah mau SMA kan? So you have to remember about this one. Now. Kita coba yang lain ya. Oke, okay, yang gampang nih. Go.
Go.
Go when?
When.
When. When. Good.
Gone.
Gone. Oke. Okay. Okay, good job. Artinya go, pergi ya. Easy. Next. Apa lagi ya? Have.
Has.
Have.
Has.
Had. Then past participle-nya ini namanya verb 3 atau past participle. Past participle. Apa? Had, have had.
Had.
Had. Good. Sama ya, have had had. Next is what about this one? Keep.
Cap.
Cap.
Capped. Then the last one is? Sama nggak? Sama. Yeah.
Cap.
So keep, cap, cap. Right? Keep, cap, cap. Now, what about give?
Give.
Gave.
Give.
Give. Give. Gave. Given.
Given.
Gave. Given. Okay, good. Now, what about? Okay, ready? This one. Here.
Heard.
Good. Siapa tadi yang bilang heard? And then last one is? Sama. Good, the same ya. Here, heard, heard. Okay, next is for forget.
Forgot, forgotten.
Good, forgotten. Ini verb 3, ini verb 1, ini ya namanya ini verb 1, verb 2, verb 3, oke. Okay. Forget, forgot, forgotten. Oke, okay, next. Forgive, what about forgive? Sama seperti mirip sih, bukan
forgiven.
Sama.
Forgive,
forgiven.
Forgiven.
Good. Forgive. Forgave.
Forgive.
Sama seperti tadi ya. Okay, good. I have difficulty in erasing. Okay, what else? Okay, sleep.
Sleep. Sleep.
Sleep, slept. Last one is sama nggak? Slept. Sleep, slept, slept. Okay. Good. Okay. Now, what about make?
Make. Is it made?
Make, made. Itu lagi? Sama dong. Make, made, made. Okay. Good. What about this one? Feel.
Felt.
Feel.
Felt. And then the verb 3, as participle-nya apa?
Felt.
Okay, good. Next, kita coba lagi. What about
new?
No tahu?
No new, no.
No new, and the verb 3 is
no.
Noun. Okay, no new noun. Okay, good. And then sell.
Salt.
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 Salt. Then the opposite of sell is buy.
Bought.
And
boat.
Ayo, udah pada ngapalin semua belum? Azhar, Renza, Rezel, Zia, Atta, Rashad, Altaf. Oke, harus dihafalin ya, mulai dihafalin dikit-dikit. Paling nggak yang basic words-nya. The one that I mentioned ini tadi adalah the basic words. And then there will be some more. Ada banyak lagi. Oke. Okay. Oh. Azza, kamu kelas berapa sekarang, Azza?
8. Naik ke 9.
Naik ke 9. Oke, okay, yes. Good. Renza, kamu naik ke kelas berapa?
8.
Oh, naik kelas 8. Oke, okay, good. Pantesan pada melempem semua. Masih SMP-SMP semua ya. Tapi nggak apa-apa. Kalian harus mulai latihan ya. Oke, okay, good. Now, I will close my whiteboard here. Now, we're going to go back to what we have earlier, to what we had earlier. This is only for introduction, yeah? For the detail one, for the detail grammar, I will tell you later in our next meetings. Okay, so last time, wait a moment, it's still loading. Okay, this one. Share my screen. Okay, kita lanjutkan yang kemarin hari Selasa. We'll continue. Now we're going to talk about the tenses in past continuous rules. Past continuous, kalau semua yang berhubungan dengan continuous, pasti belakangnya pakai apa? Verb?
Ing.
Verb ing. Nah, kalau past berarti depannya pakai past ya. She was sleeping. Past continuous. Coba sekarang kalau present continuousnya she was sleeping apa? Present continuousnya she was sleeping. Di sini kan ada she was sleeping. Ini kan past continuous. Nah sekarang kalau present continuousnya apa? She wasnya jadi
is.
She is, good. So jadinya apa? She is
sleeping.
She is sleeping. Okay, good. Jadi tinggal diganti gitu aja ya. Okay. Present continuous sama past continuous. Tinggal diganti depannya aja. Okay, good. So let's go. Okay. So she was sleeping when I came. Were they sleeping when I came? And then negatifnya, she wasn't sleepy when I came. Jadi kalian harus latihan dengan positifnya, terus cara bikin pertanyaannya seperti apa, kemudian kalimat negatifnya juga seperti apa. Okay, let's go to the next one. Let's put the correct form to past continuous. Okay, yuk kerjain bareng-bareng yuk. Ini belum kan? Okay, let's do it together, everyone. Number one, who wants to do it number one? You have to put it in the past continuous. Siapa yang mau coba?
He was cooking.
Yeah, sorry. He was cooking. Okay, who wants to do number two?
He was.
Ini ada kalimat tanyanya di sini, berarti kan to be-nya harus pertama dulu.
Was. Was he play cards?
Good. Jadi kalau kalimat tanya, kalian lihat nih ada tanda tanyanya kan berarti was she playing cards? Good. Number three, Penza, Reza, Rachel atau Altaf, silakan.
I am crying.
Hey, kok pakai M? Kita kan talking about past. M-nya diganti apa? Kalau in the past. I was crying. Crying. Good. Next, number four. Kenza or Alta, please. Ada tanda tanyanya di sini?
Are you?
Yes. Ada tanya, anda tanda tanyanya di sini. Berarti to be-nya di depan. To be-nya untuk you apa?
Where.
Where. Good.
Jadi, were you sleeping when I got home?
Were you sleeping when I got
when
home?
When I got home.
Good. Next one, number five. Zia. Zia. Zia is not around. Atta, can you please try number five? Atta atau Rashad di sini? It, to be-nya apa? To be in the past. It was atau it were?
Was.
Yeah, it was.
Raining.
Raining at lunchtime. Good. Number six. Ada kalimat tanyanya. Kalau ada kalimat tanya, berarti kita taruh dulu to be-nya di depan. What?
What were you doing?
Were you doing? Good. Number seven. Why? Ini kalimat negatif. Dan kalimat tanya.
Why she wasn't running?
Okay. Tapi kalau kalimat tanya dan negatif, berarti depannya bukan why she wasn't running, tapi dibalik. Why?
Why wasn't she running?
Good. So why wasn't she running? Kenapa dia tidak berlari? Okay. Good. Paham ya? Still manageable. Now, ini this can be past simple. This can be also past continuous. Nah, nanti kita bahas nih. I blah 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 sit in a cafe when you call. When you call. Kalian harus sesuaikan di sini. Tenses-nya apa? Okay, let me write down here. Di sini Miss kasih clue sedikit aja. Is it past simple atau past continuous? Jadi di dalam satu kalimat bisa ada dua jenis tenses. Nah, yang mana yang pakai past continuous, yang mana yang pakai past simple? Okay? Good. Yang pertama, let me give you example. I was sitting in a cafe when you called. Okay. I was sitting in a cafe. Saya sedang duduk di cafe ketika kamu menelpon atau memanggil. Call-nya pakai apa? In the past kan? Past simple atau past continuous?
Past simple.
Past simple itu artinya yang belakangnya ed, yang tadi irregular tadi ya. I was sitting in a cafe when you call. Yang mana yang sedang terjadi dulu? Yang pertama atau yang kedua? Dia duduk dulu atau dia dipanggil duluan? Yang mana yang terjadi dulu?
Jadi, duduk duluan.
Yang duduk duluan ya. Jadi dia duduk duluan. Jadi ketika dia duduk, I was sitting. Jadi saat itu dia masih duduk, and then somebody called. Terus kemudian ada yang manggil. Nah, oke, okay, kayak gitu ya logikanya ya. And then, let's try number two. Okay, let's do number two. When you arrived, pakai D.
Yes.
When you arrived
at the party, who was being the rabbit?
Who was? Boleh was, boleh were. Di sini nggak jelas ya. Who was being there? Oke, okay, kita coba yuk. Kita translate dulu. Jadi supaya kalau di translate itu supaya kalian bisa tahu artinya atau gimana cara memakainya. Oke, okay. Ini artinya apa yang nomor dua? Ketika
kamu nyampe
sampai di sebuah pesta, who was being there? Siapa yang ada di sana? Oke. Okay. Jadi yang terjadi dulu yang mana? Who was being there?
When you arrived.
No, yang terjadi dulu adalah who was being there. Siapa yang ada di sana ketika kamu datang, ya kan? Berarti kan someone itu udah ada di sana ketika kamu datang. Jadi pas kamu datang, udah ada di sana. Sebelum kamu datang, dia juga masih ada di sana. Okay, let's go number three. Susie watch a film when she hear the noise. Oke, kita lihat dulu ya, pelan-pelan ya. Susie
was watching a film when she heard the noise.
Okay, good. Susie was apa tadi?
Was watching.
Susie was watching a film when she heard. When she heard. Ketika dia mendengar. Oke, kita lihat lagi ya. Artinya apa nomor tiga nih? Susie sedang
menonton film ketika dia mendengar
suara berisik atau suara keributan. Oke. Jadi yang mana dulu yang terjadi?
Menonton.
Susi nonton TV dulu atau kemudian ada suara noise? Ya? Jadi yang mana?
Watching
ya. Oke, jadi Susi was watching film dulu, itu yang sedang terjadi kan? Nah, kemudian oke, okay, let me give you this one. Oke. Okay. Jadi seperti ini ya. Ini kan Susi nih, Susi sedang menonton TV. Oke. Okay. Terus tiba-tiba di tengah-tengah boom, ada suara noise di sini. This is the noise. Oke, okay, bayangkan seperti ini ya. Jadi ini Susie's watching movie itu dari sini ke sini. Watching film. Oke. Okay. Nah, dari sepanjang ini, dari awal sini sampai belakang, Susie was watching film. Tiba-tiba, boom, ada noise. She heard a noise. Oke, okay? Tahu ya kira-kira time frame-nya seperti apa. Oke, okay, good. Next, number four. Yesterday,
Yesterday I was going to the library. Next, I had a swim.
Later. Oh, this one can be pas simple aja ya. Jadi yang mana? Yesterday, I. No, this is something that happened already. Jadi kemarin saya go jadi apa?
When?
Yesterday I went to the library. Next, I have jadi apa? Had a swim. Later, I
met.
Later, I met Julie for coffee. Okay, paham nggak di sini? Okay, kita artiin yuk. Number four. Yesterday, kemarin saya
pergi.
Saya kepergian.
Pergi ke perpustakaan.
Setelah itu.
Kemudian saya ada les berenang. Kemudian
saya bertemu dengan Julian untuk
Juli untuk minum kopi. Oke, good. Nah, sekarang kita coba number five. Nomor lima ini sama seperti ini, tapi ini kita ganti jadi playing tennis di sini. Kan? Oke, number five. How do you make it, number five? We
play.
We. Past continuous, past simple.
We were playing tennis.
Good. We were playing tennis. We were playing tennis when John hurt. Jadi hurt-nya sama enggak? When John hurt his ankle. Oke, artinya apa? Nomor lima? Kita
sedang bermain tenis
ketika
John terkena ankle.
Oke, ketika ankle-nya atau mata kaki John sakit. Oke. Ya. Yang mana yang terjadi dulu? We were playing tennis dulu atau John hurt his ankle? Yang mana dulu yang terjadi?
Main tennis.
Okay, next number six. Okay, ini ada di sini. What
were they doing?
No, kalau last night, berarti udah selesai. Bukan sedang terjadi.
What are they doing?
No, what, kalau what? Pakai di sini pakainya do ya. Kalau do nggak pakai to be. Oke, tunggu. Kalian pasti masih bingung ya. It's okay. What did they? Ini tadi they atau you? Okay, what did they do at 10 p.m. last night? It was really noisy. Okay. Jadi kalau di sininya do, sesuatu yang berhubungan dengan kegiatan, activity, kalian kata depannya harus ganti pakai did, kalau untuk past ya. Tapi kalau misalnya di sini miss ganti sleepy. Sleepy itu ngantuk atau tidur?
Ngantuk.
Ngantuk itu kata kerja atau kata sifat?
Sifat.
Kata kerjanya sifat. Tidur kan? Nah, yeah. Kalau miss ganti di sini jadi they sleepy, karena kata sifat, jadi kata sifat tuh pasangannya dengan to be. Jadi, why they, why were they sleepy yesterday, for example. Tapi kalau Miss ganti jadi sleep di sini. Kita ubah jadi ini, did they sleep yesterday? Ya, karena di sini kata kerja. Oke, tambah bingung pastinya. Let's go to number seven first. Oke. Ini dia sedang mandi ketika teleponnya berbunyi. Something in the past. Yuk, dia sedang mandi ketika teleponnya berbunyi. Sama seperti ini ya. Dia sedang mandi. Nih, garis lurus nih sedang mandi. Terus tiba-tiba telepon bunyi. Boom. Kring, kring, kring di sini. So,
he was taking a shower when the telephone rang.
Good. He was taking shower. Dia sedang mandi ketika teleponnya ring, rang, rung. Jadi, jadinya ring, rang. Okay. When the telephone rang. Okay, let's go to number eight. When ini sama seperti ini juga.
When I was walking to the room, everyone work.
When I was walking, when I was walking into the room, everyone worked. Okay. Oke, ketika saya sedang berjalan di ruangan, semua orang bekerja. Everyone work. Oke, next number nine. Ini nomor 8 bisa jadi seperti ini ya. Bisa jadi misalnya kalian lagi di kelas. Oke, atau misalnya lagi di kantor nih ya. When I was walking into the room, tiba-tiba semua orang bekerja. Jadi yang jalan ini kira-kira bosnya atau bukan? Ya, bisa jadi ya. Jadi ketika bosnya datang ke ruangan, semuanya, ya, you can say they pretend working. Oke, let's do number nine.
What?
It? It was a last day. It was a day last September. It was a day last September. The sun. Burung. To be kan was sama were. Right? To be in the past to was sama were. The sun was shining. Matahari bersinar. The birds. Yo. Kalau di sini ada kata and, biasanya ya, kalau di sini ada kata and, biasanya yang di sini dan di sini itu harus sama pola kalimatnya. Jadi di sini apa? And the birds
were singing.
Were singing. And the birds were singing. Okay. I was walking the street atau I walked along the street.
I walked along the street when I met an old friend.
I, saya sedang berjalan di menyusuri jalan ketika saya bertemu teman lama saya. Jadi apa? Saya sedang berjalan menyusuri jalan. I was walking. I was walking along the street when I
met
a note. Okay, good job everyone. Okay, let's give applause to all of you that you can do this one. Okay, I know it's not easy, but you have to know about this. Okay, let's go to the next one. Do you need some more? Kita coba lagi ya. Wait. Okay, langsung aja yuk. Kita coba. Oke, dia sedang tinggal di Rusia ketika revolusi dimulai.
He was living
in Russia when the revolution
started.
Good. Okay, saya. Good job. Next, number two. Ketika keretanya sampai di stasiun, kita sedang menunggu di peron. Ini dibolak-balik nih sebenarnya. Yang mana yang dulu, yang duluan? Keretanya sampai dulu atau mereka nunggu dulu di peron?
Nunggu dulu.
Okay. Jadi kalau mereka nunggu dulu berarti ketika kita menunggu di peron. Jadi apa? We were waiting on the platform. Platform ini peron ya. Okay, this one. Ketika kita menunggu di peron, her train get menjadi
got.
Okay, good. Next, number three.
He was being
He was being so annoying. Dia sangat menyebalkan. He always. Kalau always pakainya apa? He always leaves. Karena pakai always ya, jadi kita pakainya present simple aja. Okay, good. Number four. On holiday, pada saat liburan, kita mengunjungi Roma, melihat kota Vatikan, dan menghabiskan beberapa hari di pantai. Nah, kalau ini pas simple semua nih. Ini pas simple semua. Ayo, kalau pas simple apa? Easy ya. On holiday, we visited Rome, koma. Nah, kalau ada koma, biasanya kalimat keduanya juga sama. Ini verb kedua juga. Visited. Oh. Kalau di sini kan nggak ada si, jadinya so, good. Then, and, spend jadinya apa?
Spend.
Belakangnya apa? D atau T? Okay. And spent few days at the beach. Okay. Number five. Kenapa kamu berdiri di atas kursi ketika saya datang ke dalam ruangan? Yang mana dulu yang terjadi? Dia berdiri dulu di kursi atau saya datang ke ruang?
Berdiri di kursi.
Berdiri di kursi. Kalau berdiri di kursi berarti why were you standing on a chair when I came. Good. When I came. Good. Next, number six. Mereka pada saat dulu mereka ketika mereka tinggal di Jerman, mereka masih muda. Okay. Past continuous-nya?
Live.
Sorry. Okay. Yang mana yang terjadi dulu? Ketika mereka masih muda dulu atau yeah, mereka live in Germany? Okay, kita coba pakai ini dulu yuk. When they were young. When they were being young. They apa di sini? Mereka tinggal di Jerman ketika where they were being young. Wait, let me also. They lived in Germany when they were being young. Okay, you can use this or you can use the other way around. Also can also it's possible too. They were living in Germany when they were young. Itu juga bisa. Jadi dua-duanya boleh ya. Okay. Good number seven. Ketika saya meninggalkan rumah, saat itu sedang bersalju, sedang turun salju. Yang mana yang sedang turun salju itu kita pakai apa? It was snowing or it snowed?
It was snowing.
Good. It was snowing. Karena sedang terjadi. And then when I left the house atau when I was leaving the house?
I was leaving the house.
Dan ketika sedang salju, boom, I left the house. Ya kan? I left the house. Jadi ini terjadi cuma sekali. I left the house ini. When I left the house, it was snow. Good. Number eight. So first of all, what you have to do is you have to understand the sentence, the meaning of the sentence. Okay. Number eight. Dia bekerja di bank ketika dia bertemu istrinya. He was working in a bank when he met his wife. Next, last one. Apa yang sedang kamu lakukan ketika saya menelponmu semalam?
What did you do?
Ayo, logikanya coba dicari dulu.
What were you doing when I called you last night?
Ya, jadi apa yang sedang kamu lakukan ketika saya menelpon kamu? What were you doing when I called you last night? Ya, jadi ini sama seperti tadi. Apa yang sedang kamu lakukan when I home called you last night? Okay. Okay, you have to understand the sentence first. Okay. Next, past perfect. Past perfect itu kita pakai verb ketiga ya atau past participle. For example, okay, I want you to read.
It's already 5 minutes left. We only talk about one tenses. Okay, baca ya. Siapa yang mau baca? Biar nggak ngantuk. Siapa tadi yang nggak ada suaranya ya? Renza, can you please read? Zia juga, Aisyah juga. Renza, can you please read 3 sentences? Zia, the next 2 sentences. Raisha, the next 2-3 sentences. Please, Renza.
A finished section before a second point in the past. When we arrived, the film had started. First, the film started, then we arrived.
Okay, next.
I'd eaten dinner, so I wasn't hungry.
Okay, I'd eaten di sini artinya I had eaten ya. Okay, next.
It had snowed in the night, so the bus didn't arrive.
Arrive. Okay, good. Zia, can you read the next 2 sentences, please?
When he got...
graduated. Graduated artinya lulus.
When he graduated, he had been in London for 6 years. He arrived in London. And lived there until he graduated.
He graduated. Graduated.
Graduated or even longer.
Graduated, yeah. Wait, let me check.
On the
or even longer. Then next, on the 20th
of July,
I had work here
for three months.
Good. Next, Rashad, can you please read the next one? The next
is I had known you were, I would have visited you.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Pass the exam if she had studied harder.
Okay.
I wish I hadn't gone to bed so late.
Okay, good. Jadi kalau yang pertama yang dibaca Renza tadi, a finished action before a second point in the past. Jadi ada 2 kejadian di sini. Yang pertama, ketika kita datang, film sudah dimulai. Yang mana dulu yang terjadi?
Film dimulai.
Filmnya dimulai dulu kan, baru kita datang, ya kan? Okay, and then number 2, I had eaten dinner, so I wasn't hungry. Saya sudah makan malam, jadi saya tidak lapar. Yang mana yang sudah terjadi dulu? Saya sudah makan dulu atau saya tidak lapar?
Makan malam dulu.
Ya, makan malam dulu, so I wasn't hungry. Ya, kalau di sini, kalau yang sudah terjadi duluan, kita pakainya seperti ini, had plus verb ketiga. Terus kemudian, it had snowed in the night, so the bus didn't arrive. Salju sudah turun, jadi busnya tidak bisa datang. Kenapa busnya tidak bisa datang?
Because I was...
Why the bus didn't arrive? Because it had snowed, ya. Yeah? Jadi 2 kejadian. Yang mana dulu yang terjadi? Had snowed atau bus had didn't snowed. Arrive? Had snowed. Yeah. Okay, and then number 2, something that had started in the past and continued up to another action or time in the past. Ketika dia lulus, when he graduated, ketika dia lulus, dia telah berada di London selama 6 tahun. Jadi yang mana dulu yang sudah terjadi? Dia tinggal di London dulu atau dia lulus dulu? Pokoknya
tinggal di London.
Dia tinggal di London dulu dong. Ya, oke, good. He had been in London. Dia tinggal di London dulu, kemudian he graduated. Ya, ingat ya tingkatan katanya ya. Kalau pakai had plus verb ketiga berarti itu udah terjadi dulu, baru dia lulus. Pada 20 Juli saya telah I'd di sini I had worked here for 3 months. Saya telah bekerja selama 3 bulan. Okay, and then next to talk about unreal or imaginary things in the past. Kalau saja saya tahu kalau kamu sedang sakit, saya akan mengunjungi kamu. So this is about something which is unreal. Buktinya apa? Buktinya dia tahu nggak kalau dia sakit? Nggak tahu. Oke. Okay. Ini nanti kalian belajar ini di SMA kelas 2 atau kelas 3. Dan di universitas juga nanti kalian akan belajar ini. Makanya kalian harus tahu basicnya dulu, baru nanti naik kelas ya. And then number 2, she would have passed the exam if she had studied harder. Jadi dia lulus atau tidak?
Nope.
No. Yeah, because this is something about unreal. She would have passed the exam if she had studied harder. Then next, I wish I hadn't gone to bed so late. Saya berharap saya tidak tidur terlalu malam. Buktinya apakah dia tidur malam?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So this is unreal. Jadi berimajinasi. Sesuatu yang nggak mungkin terjadi karena sudah terjadi. Okay. Good. I think that's all. Do you want to play games or not? No? Thank you. Okay, this is the rules, yeah. Person, subject plus had plus verb 3. Had dulu, subject plus verb 3. And then kalau negatif, subject plus had not, hadn't, plus verb 3. Okay, good? You want to try again, this one or not? Mau coba lagi nggak? Already 9 o'clock. It's okay. I can give you more. Are you willing to do more? Kita coba lagi ya. Let's do it quickly. When I arrive at the cinema, the film
started.
Sudah mulai.
The film had started.
Had star. Diikuti kata kerja ketiga. Had star. Had started. Ketika saya datang di bioskop, filmnya sudah mulai. Then number 2. Setelah mereka makan kerang, mereka merasa sakit.
After they eating.
Kan di sini ada begin. Yang mana dulu yang terjadi? Begin to feel sick dulu atau mereka makan dulu? Makan dulu kan? Nah, karena di sini kita bahas tentang past perfect, berarti kita pakainya rumusnya apa? Had it jadi apa?
Eaten.
Had eaten. Okay. Jadi kalian harus tahu tingkatannya. Jadi mereka sudah makan kerang dulu, baru mereka mulai sakit. Okay. This one. Kalau kamu mendengarkan saya, kamu pasti sudah dapat pekerjaan. This is something unreal, sesuatu yang tidak mungkin terjadi. If you, ini kan pakai had, ayo. Berarti pakai coba apa? Coba gimana? If you
had
apa? Listen, kata kerja ketiganya apa? Regular verb. Kalau regular berarti harus ditambahin apa belakangnya?
Listen.
If you had listened to me, kalau kamu coba, kalau kamu dengerin aku, kamu pasti akan dapat kerjaan. Tapi kenyataannya tidak. Next, number 4.
Julie didn't
arrive until I. Okay, jadi dia, nih kita lihat dua kalimatnya. Julie tidak datang, tidak akan datang, atau tidak datang sampai saya. Jadi ini ceritanya musuhan nih.
Julie tidak datang sampai saya pergi. Atau bukan ya, Julie didn't arrive until I, ayo, apa nih, past perfect, had left. Okay, Julie tidak datang sampai saya udah pulang. Jadi dia nungguin, bisa jadi dia nungguin Julie ya, tapi Julie tidak datang. Okay, number five. Ayo, ini pakai tanda tanya. Kalau pakai tanda tanya, yang depannya apa dulu, guys? Had
I read the book before the class?
Ya, had I read the book before the class? Apakah saya sudah membaca buku sebelum kelas? Okay.
Had it been...
Ayo. Yes, apa? Kalau B, verb ketiganya apa?
Had it been cold all week.
Ya, had it been cold all week. Had it been cold all week. Okay, guys. I think that's all. Do you have any question? Yeah. The more you practice, and then the better you will be. All right? Don't stop trying. Don't give up. This is only the introduction. So tomorrow we are still going to talk about this, but we're going to talk about the future next meeting. Yeah, kita bahas the basic part dulu. Okay. Good. I know you must be very sleepy because of distances, but don't give up. All right. Thank you for coming today in Kiri English course. Have a nice weekend. Have a nice rest. Thank you for coming. And assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye bye.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam. Thank you, Miss.
Welcome. Bye bye. Jangan pusing ya.
Yeah.